Welcome to again a movie of using Python in Spider. The video before that we looked at a for loop, and we saw that everything which was indented here, so put to the right, it executes it multiple times depending on what kind of stuff you've written here. Okay. And actually, we can do more with that, because we can also nest loops. What does that mean? That means that we can put loops within loops, and that's also a very powerful programming technique. And I'm going to show that using with a new variable x value, and I'm going to say x has to go from 0 to 3. And here I'm going to say, but y value has to go from 0 to 5. And here we're just going to, and I forgot the double dot, so I have to do like this. And here we're going to print, let's say, x value and y value. And let's make it a little bit nicer. So I'm going to say x is equal to, and here we're gonna say y is, this is just for formatting the output of what you see. So basically I'm printing x value, y value. Let's see if I've made no errors. We don't see if I made something stupid there like this. You will see here something strange. It says, well, I don't understand it now already. Sometimes Python gives errors during execution. We've seen that in movie 3 or 4, I think. But also, even before execution, Python can already say, I've got no clue what you want. And then you see something like this popping up, and you can see already this. He says, I don't know what you mean with L. I don't know what you mean with SIKDGG. So please remove it. Okay, let's remove it. So, but we don't see any errors right now. So let's see what's happened when we run it. Okay. What is happening here? And this is actually really good to think about this a little bit longer, because this is actually quite interesting, useful, but also a little bit difficult. So what does the program do? It first does this statement. What does this statement say? Okay, I have to do everything which is indented afterwards. So that is this whole thing. I have to do 3 times for x value 0, 1 and 2. Okay, so what is this thing I have to do 3 times? Then he sees this sentence, and this sentence says, this thing, the print, I have to do 5 times for y value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it does this 5 times, and then it goes back here, and this sentence says, well, you have to still do it also for x value is 1. And then it does this 5 times, this thing, and then again it goes back here and says, well, you have to do this for x value is 2. And that's exactly what we see here happening. So we see here that the first time both x and y are 0. Then it executes this one again, because it's inside this for loop. So y is increased to 1, and then to 2, and then to 3, then to 4. Then the y value is finished, and it goes back to this loop. So the x value loop, and there we see, okay, now I increase x, and then we start all over again with this thing. So then again, y is started with 0. Well, this kind of thing is really nice because you can go to a grid, basically. You can go to, if you've got a grid, a 2x2, so you've got values in the x direction, the y direction, and everywhere in between. But this way, you can go to all those different steps. That's really nice. Let's go to the next movie.